Hi, I'm Yao from the Infor OS enablement team, and in this video, I'll be showing you how to integrate Infor Document Management into CloudSuite Industrial. This integration, enabled by ION, which is the pillar of Infor OS, allows the CSI user to store related documents for any order at scale. The objective of this video will be to demo a walkthrough of how CSI pushes purchase orders into Document Management. Afterwards, I will show you how you can use the In Context section within Infor Mingle to show corresponding documents that we just uploaded to a particular order. Before I begin, here are some additional resources to provide more information on document management and CSI. You'll see here a link to Mongoose, which is what CSI is built off of. I'm now inside CSI with my purchase orders form opened. I would like to see my order report for this particular order. That's easy. I can just click on the purchase order report and generate the PDF. But let's say now I want to keep track of the report associated with this order and see it within my related information section. For this, I can utilize document management for storage and tagging. So let me show you how this works and I can explain the steps. First, let's generate the order report. I'll keep all the settings as is and click print. After a minute or so, you should see the generated order report. And if we go in back into CSI, we can see the report has been submitted. Let's check our document management and see if the document has been uploaded. I can now see my purchase order for 339 stored into IDM. If I go back into my CloudSuite Industrial and open up my purchase orders form, in the related information, I can now see my order report that is stored in IDM. Clicking into it, I can get a full screen view of the report. This capability allows users to easily associate multiple documents with each order without storing them in CSI itself. Now that you've seen the walkthrough, let's go through the steps on how it works. CSI has a core event listener, an AES, or application event system, that gets triggered after the order report has been generated. I can see that it has a handler called Execute IDM Archive. Going into the handler, I can see there is a sequence of actions. The two I want to highlight of the action sequence is 20 and 80. Action 20 checks whether the task performed is set to active. So if the user wants to archive more than just purchase orders, they can open up the IDM Document Workflows form and check whichever task they want to be marked as active. If the task is set to active, it will run the subsequent event actions, one of which archives the documents into IDM. So in this case, I have all my purchase orders set to active, which will allow for the archiving of all the purchase orders into IDM. Action 80 is making the ION API connection to IDM to archive the report. In another video, I will show you how to set up CSI or Mongoose to use ION API within forms, AES, and custom assemblies.